Hi, my name's Trev Hutchings, and this is how to set up the Native Instruments Komplete Kontrol with the Vortex Wireless 2. In the Vortex preset editor, set all pads to CC toggle, set MIDI channel to 1, set off to 0, and on to 127, and make sure all the pads have different CC numbers. Set pad 1, color 1 and 4 to green. Set pad 2, color 1 and 4 to cyan. Set pad 3, color 1 and 4 to white. Set pad 4, color 1 and 4 to red. Set pad 7, color 1 and 4 to orange. And set pad 8, color 1 and 4 to yellow. Check all the faders are set to channel 1. Set pad 1 to CC number 1, which is modulation. And set release mode to latch. Finally, set tilt to CC number 1 as well. To install Komplete Kontrol, go to www.native-instruments.com/en/catalog/free and click on Complete Start. You will need to set up an account and follow the instructions to install native access. Komplete Kontrol and all additional software will be added to native access. Open native access and select the Not Installed tab. Click on Install All. Sit back and wait for the software to download and install. Click on the Komplete Kontrol icon on your desktop. At the top left of the screen, click on Edit. Click on Preferences and select your audio interface on the Audio tab page. Make sure your Vortex is on and connected to your computer. Click on the MIDI tab, click on the Input button, and click the tick box next to the Vortex Wireless 2. Click on Close button. Click on All Instruments. Click on the Contact plugin. Click on the Guitar Group heading in Types. And double click on Rock Guitar. At the top right of the screen, click on the MIDI tab. Click on the first knob and then move Fader 1 on the Vortex. Click on the second knob and then move Fader 2 on the Vortex. Continue with all 8 knobs and faders. Click on the Buttons tab. Click on the first button and then tap Pad 1 on the Vortex. Click on the second button and tap Pad 2 on the Vortex. Click on the third button and tap pad 3 on the Vortex. Then click on the fourth button and tap pad 4 on the Vortex. Click on the fifth button and then tap pad 7 on the Vortex. And finally click on the sixth button and then tap pad 8 on the Vortex. Now click on the MIDI tab. Near the top of the screen, click on the controls icon. The Vortex faders will now control these control knobs. Click on the Edit icon to change the controls. Move the mouse over a knob. Click on the X to delete the knob control. Or click on the down arrow to select a different available control. Click on the second tab to see the second page of control knobs. Click on the plus sign to add an additional control knobs page. Click on the edit icon to lock the settings. Use pads 7 and 8 on the Vortex to switch between pages. The 8 faders will automatically control the knobs of the current page. The plugin icon allows you to add an effects plugin. Click on the plugin icon and click to the right of the instrument. Click on All Effects to select a plugin. Click on a plugin and double click on an effect. Pads 3 and 4 on the Vortex switch between instrument and effects plugins. Pads 1 and 2 switch between the available effects of the effects plugin when the effects plugin is selected with pads 3 or 4. At the top left of the screen, click on File. Click on Save As. Change the name of the preset and click Save. Click on the user icon to show your user saved presets. Click on the user icon again to show the factory presets. In this demo, I'm using the Kontakt rock guitar. Moving fader 6 halfway down sets the wah to modulation. I set touchpad 1 and the tilt to CC number 1 so they control modulation. So sliding my finger up and down on touchpad 1 or turning on tilt and moving the Vortex up and down now simulates a wah pedal. So now the Vortex and Komplete Kontrol are set up. If you've enjoyed this video, do give us a thumbs up and click on that subscribe button. Cheers.